About 5 years ago, Eric's life had run off the road. His wife had left him. He was unemployed and tipping the scales at about 560 pounds. He decided to take on a big feat and attempt to ride his bike across America without any training. After he became an internet sensation, he says the haters tried to take him down. So he quit, even though I tried to help him with a food delivery service and a top-notch trainer, Robert Reames. But that wasn't good enough for Eric.
After the show, Dr. Phil had Robert Reames help me with diet and exercise.
Well, I've been on the Dr. Phil Show now 17 seasons as the head trainer and nutritionist.
I didn't feel like Robert actually cared about me. All Robert really did was call to see how much I weighed.
If you're consistent in your efforts, you cannot lose.
He sent me a little watch thing, but it didn't fit. We could never get it working so he could keep track of my heart rate. When I spoke with Robert on the phone, I would usually blog about it on my website so my followers would hear everything.
I walk the walk the best I can.
At one point where he had told me that, you know, I could eat sausage for breakfast. And so I posted about it, you know, I was having sausage, and they just tore him apart. That's too much salt or this, or he can't be doing that. And it was really bad for his image. And then he retracted his statement and said he never said it. He was trying to cover himself because of the harassment. Robert was majorly too concerned with hurting his own career than to help me. Working with Robert did feel like I was working with a scared little girl.
I know Robert Reames personally. I've worked with Robert Reames as a trainer personally for, I don't know, Rob, what, 15 years, 16 yeah. years, 17 yeah. years? I've worked with him on nutrition. I've worked with him as a trainer. Robin's worked with Robert, and I have never met anyone that was more motivated, devoted, caring, more technically precise, more involved and devoted, and have probably had him involved with, I don't know, 40 or 50 people on the show here over the last 16, 17 years, and he has never failed to succeed except for you. Robert, you ran into your Waterloo here.
Yeah, I did.
You say Eric is the first client that you've ever wanted to fire. Why did you want to fire him?
Well, you know, at the time, you know, Eric says I wasn't prepared, or Eric says I didn't care. I mean, everybody knows, again, Phil, you and Robin, you just said, you know how I work. You know, if anything, I care too much. And I really gave Eric all I had. I gave him 10 months. And it was excuse after excuse after excuse. Because he didn't want to learn. He knew everything.
If you do what Robert says, you will get results. You won't kind of get results. You will get results. And you will learn to do it the right way, where you don't injure yourself, so you don't have problems after the fact. So, you know, don't defend yourself, Robert Reames, because you don't have to. I'll do that for you. And I look
that.
At Robert's text to Eric, and I mean, it's Robert was in communication with Eric from February to November of 16. And Robert says he would email, call, and text, but Eric blew him off. February 6th, called yesterday, called today, sent another email, no response. 7/18, never heard from you. 8/7, Eric, I'm not hearing anything from you. No weigh-ins, no journals. 8/15, trying to connect with you again, not hearing from you. 9/8, Eric, where are you? 11/26, haven't heard from you. I mean, just on and on and on.
I kind of gave up after I lost face. I think you're a great trainer. I just think we clashed.
What about all the time he spent trying to help you and you were blowing him off?
I rode my bicycle every day, and he wanted me to use the pair device so he could keep track of it and teach me how to use a roller.
I raised you a food service where you didn't have to make any choices. Take the lid off, eat what's in there, go do something else. Take the next lid off, eat what's in there, do something else. They fired you after 4 months.
We tried our best to.
Because you wouldn't weigh in.
It's not that I wouldn't weigh in. It was hard to find places to weigh in.
Well, there's a consistent theme of noncompliance here.